Hello, cadets, parents, family, and friends. Welcome to Mesa High School's Air Force Junior ROTC Virtual Annual Award Ceremony. I'm Cadet David Clement.
And I'm Cadet Diage Moore.
And we are the master and mistress of the ceremony.
At this time, we ask that you all please rise and place your right hand over your heart for the presentation of the colors and the singing of the national anthem sung by our very own AFJROTC choir.
Gary, goes! Forward, march! Left face wheel, march! Freeze that, goes! Front face wheel, punch!
Thank you. Please be seated. It is no surprise that the group that provides the most support to each individual cadet as well as the program as a whole are our parents, guardians, relatives, and friends. Their continuous support is critical to the success of our program. Also, we wish to thank Mesa High's teachers and staff for their outstanding support for our unit.
Now, we would like to present a video that honors a group of individuals who played an important role in making our unit what it is today.
New friends and new places to see. With blue skies ahead, yes, I'm on my way. And there's nowhere else that I'd rather be. Tell everybody I'm on my way. And I'm loving every step I take. With the sun beating down, yes, I'm.
We will now begin the formal part of the ceremony and recognize those cadets who were selected to receive national awards.
Air Force Association Award. This award is presented annually to an outstanding cadet displaying a positive attitude towards AFJROTC, outstanding personal appearance and uniform personal attributes such as initiative, judgment, and self-confidence. This displays growth potential towards accepting greater responsibility and leadership. This year's AFA recipient is Cadet David Clement.
Order of the Dedalions. The Order of the Dedalions is a fraternity of commissioned pilots from all military services. It is named after the legendary figure Daedalus, and was organized by World War I commissioned military pilots who sought to perpetuate the spirit of patriotism, love of country, and the highest ideals of self-sacrifice, which placed service to the nation above personal safety and position. This award is offered to encourage the development of these traits in junior ROTC cadets and to interest them in a military career. This year, the Dedalion Award recipient is Cadet Angel Carbajal.
American Legion Scholastic Award. The American Legion Scholastic Award is presented annually to recognize a cadet for overall scholastic achievement. This cadet is ranked in the top 10% of their aerospace science class. This cadet demonstrates exceptional leadership qualities and actively participates in unit activities. This year's recipient is Cadet Ashley Villatoro.
The American Legion General Military Excellence Award. This award recognizes a cadet who displays an excellent military image. This cadet demonstrates outstanding quality in military leadership, discipline, character, and citizenship. This year's recipient is Cadet Melanie Lopez.
Daughters of the American Resolution Award. The award is presented to a cadet who demonstrates good character and disciplinary adherence to military standards and discipline, possesses strong leadership abilities, and a fundamental patriotic understanding of the importance of JROTC training. The cadet selected to receive this award is Cadet Marina Castellano.
The Reserve Officer Association Award. The ROA Award is presented to recognize a cadet that demonstrates a positive attitude towards AFJROTC, outstanding personal appearance, positive attributes of initiative, judgment, and self-confidence, and displays a high set of personal and ethical standards. The recipient is Cadet Devin Walter.
The Military Order of the World Wars, the MOWW Award, is presented annually to an outstanding cadet who has committed to continuing the aerospace program in the upcoming school year. Selection is based on outstanding accomplishments and service to the unit. This year's recipient is Cadet Luis Vieira.
The Military Officers Association of America presents awards to three different cadets. The first award is a medal presented to a cadet who shows exceptional potential in the area of military leadership. This cadet is of high moral character and participates in the majority of activities conducted by the unit. This cadet displays a high order of loyalty to the unit, school, and country. This year's recipient is Cadet Hattori Talafoga.
The MOAA Superstition Mountain Patriotism Award, represented by our nation's most prized symbol, our flag, is presented to a cadet that has demonstrated the attributes and traits of American patriotism. This flag was flown over our nation's capital in Washington, D.C. The recipient is Cadet Melissa Clear.
The Superstition Mountain JROTC Military Achievement Award. The purpose of this award is to raise awareness of the Military Officers Association of America and to encourage cadets to consider serving their country through military service. This award is presented to the cadet whose performance and leadership upholds the values of the United States military. Our recipient tonight is Cadet Betsy Diaz.
Veterans of Foreign Wars Award. This award is presented to a cadet who is actively engaged in the AFJROTC program and possesses individual characteristics contributing to leadership, maintains strong military bearing, and conducts disciplined and positive attitude, and sets an example for others. The recipient is Cadet Melissa Carbajal.
National Sojourners Award. This award is presented to a cadet who displays outstanding potential for growth within the unit. This cadet also demonstrates and supports American and unit values within the cadet corps. The recipient is Cadet Kira Ayon.
Sons of the American Resolution Award. The recipient of this award exhibits a great potential for future leadership roles, maintains a high degree of military bearing, and performs outstanding in his aerospace studies. The recipient is Cadet Andrew Diaz.
The Scottish Rite of Freemasonry Award. The Scottish Rite is a fraternal organization whose members embrace the high social, moral, and spiritual values to include fellowship, compassion, and dedication to God, family, and country. This award is presented to a cadet who maintains a high level of educational excellence and demonstrates a strong sense of Americanism. The recipient is Cadet Miriam Fuentes.
Military Order of the Purple Heart. The cadet selected for this award has demonstrated strong leadership abilities and displays a positive attitude towards AFJROTC and our country. This cadet actively participates in both school and community activities. This recipient is Cadet Megan Johnson.
Air Force Sergeants Association. This award recognizes a cadet who demonstrates qualities in military leadership, discipline, character, and citizenship. This year's recipient is Cadet Emerita Caseda.
Turkish Airman Award. This award is presented to two cadets within the unit who have displayed a positive attitude and have participated in a large portion of cadet activities. Both cadets have maintained good standing within the corps and have participated in supporting scheduled unit service activities. This year's recipients are Cadet Brianna Henry and Cadet Daniel DeCamps.
Air Commando Association Award. This award is presented to one cadet who most closely exemplifies the 13 critical attributes of success for Air Commandos. These attributes include integrity, self-motivation, self-discipline, adaptability, maturity, and perseverance. The recipient is Cadet Daniela Blaine.
American Veterans Award. This award is presented to a cadet that demonstrates a positive attitude towards AFJROTC, demonstrates a neat and personal appearance, demonstrates outstanding personal attributes and initiative, disciplinary judgment, and self-confidence, demonstrates leadership potential, and must have maintained a grade of A in AFJROTC. The recipient is Cadet Giselle Solis. Additionally, the Military Order of the World War sponsors the East Valley Cadet of the Year Award with prizes for first, second, and third place. This is a very competitive award that includes all branches of service with over 25 JROTC units and 2,000 cadets in the East Valley. The cadet that finished in first place for the East Valley Cadet of the Year, congratulations to our very own Cadet Dylan Caldwell.
Please join me in a round of applause for all of our national award winners.
Now we would like to recognize the cadets selected to receive the 2020-2021 Distinguished Cadet Award for each class.
The following cadets have been selected as outstanding cadets for their respective flights. They have each displayed a high level of commitment and loyalty to the unit as a whole and to each of their flights. Each cadet is selected by the AFJROTC staff members. Our outstanding cadets for the 2020-2020 academic year are, from Alpha Flight, Cadet Marissa Carvajal.
From Bravo Flight, Cadet Betsy Diaz.
From Charlie Flight, Cadet Hattori Talafoga.
From Delta Flight, Cadet Marina Castellano.
From Echo Flight, Cadet Daniel DeCamps. The outstanding remote cadet is Cadet Genesis Shapiro.
The Arden Rally Distinguished Cadet is named after Major Arden Riley, this great American passed away in 2019. Major Riley was a Mesa High school graduate and served as a mentor to our cadets. He enlisted in the Army during the Korean War and was later captured and held as a POW for 33 months. He deeply loved and was dedicated to his country, community, and friends. The distinguished cadet is the one cadet in the unit that has far exceeded the standards and requirements set by headquarters, AFJROTC, and the senior aerospace science instructor. This person exemplifies the Air Force Corps values of integrity first, service before self, and excellence in all we do. This cadet represents the best of the best and is awarded the highest honor presented to any cadet by their unit. The Arden Riley Distinguished Cadet Award for the 2020-2021 academic year is Cadet David Clement.
At this time, we would like our unit commander, Lieutenant Colonel Brian Walker, to say a few words.
Good evening, cadets, and congratulations to all the award winners. Remember, you earned those awards through your dedication and hard work. To our senior class, we're going to miss each of you. After graduation, please come back and visit. Also, I want to thank the contributing national organizations for their support and for making the JROTC Awards Night possible. Folks, we have an outstanding JROTC program. We would be on pace to earn our 8th straight national level Air Force JROTC Distinguished Unit Award, except headquarters has decided to suspend that award for this school year because of the pandemic. Still, your accomplishments are laudable, and that is a direct result of everyone pulling the rope in the same direction and making great things happen. A special thanks to our group commander, Cadet Lieutenant Colonel Uribe, and the entire command staff. The cadet command staff is responsible for planning, organizing, leading, and controlling all the various JROTC activities and events. This year has been especially challenging to plan activities and stay motivated since we started the year in remote learning, went to hybrid learning, then 5 days a week learning, back to hybrid, back to remote, back to hybrid, and now back to 5 days a week. Additionally, about 30% of the cadets elected to remain in remote learning. Despite the circumstances, the cadet command staff and senior class did what leaders do. They got to work. They were resilient and proactive. They came up with innovative ways to reach all cadets by creating training videos and uploading them onto our new unit YouTube channel, as well as using our unit Facebook page and Instagram account to keep the cadets informed. They even developed a survey to determine how the cadets were holding up during the pandemic and how the command staff could better serve them. They did a phenomenal job. Master Sergeant Caldwell and I are very proud of you. Finally, thanks to the parents, guardians, teachers, and school staff for their dedication to our program, especially Mr. Thomas, our principal, for making JROTC a priority. He fully supports the program and appreciates the level of professionalism that you, the cadets, bring to Mesa High School. I am looking forward to August when we return to school with yet another outstanding team of cadets. Until then, stay motivated and keep working hard. Carry on.
We have a long-standing tradition for the AZ-931st Award Night Program. A cadet-prepared video that shows the love of friendships that words could never capture.
Share the night.
And now, a few final words from our graduating group commander, Cadet Lieutenant Colonel Joshua Uribe.
State your full name and your rank.
I am Lieutenant Colonel Uribe, Joshua Uribe.
What was your favorite experience in ROTC?
I would say my favorite experience was when I went to my first field trip. It was Heroes Run. That was when I got really close with lots of people and like made lots of friendships. And it was really nice because I at first wasn't really that close with anyone, nor was I really talking to anyone. But once that like hit, I don't know, everyone just got so close to one another and it was a great experience.
What was your favorite event?
My favorite event, I would say Vikings, the Vikings challenge. That was really intense. The one that happened last year, you know, everyone was very, very hyped. We were like low on students and we still made it happen. Cadet Freeland, she did it really, really well. Like, she was in charge of the whole event, and it was very, I could see that it was very stressful for her, but she ended up pulling through, so that was really cool. Lots of people, you know, we all had a very great experience. We all doubted ourselves for a little bit, but you know, at the end of the day, we still pulled through, we still helped with one another, and then I feel like Tug of War really acknowledged the fact that we all worked really great as a team. We came up with a strategy with Tug of War. We were like the underdogs. We failed the first time, but we came back like very, very strong. I guess that just shows how committed we are to finishing the job.
What are you gonna miss most?
I would say I'm gonna miss the people the most. Yeah, just like all the friendships that I made, you know, the first years, second years, third years, even the seniors. It was very, for me personally, it was a family aspect. It really was. I see everyone as like my little siblings, like the lower classmen, and then like my class, I see them as my brothers and sisters. So it was it's a very, very nice experience, you know, getting to be with them for all 4 years and even getting to train the first years and second years. And it's really cool that some of them say that they look up to me, because that's all I really like. I really wanted to make like an impact in their life, and I feel like I did that. So, yeah.
From each class, which cadet are you gonna miss the most?
From each class, I don't think I could really answer that. Okay, so let's see. Alpha Flight, me. Echo Flight, me. Delta Flight, me. Charlie Flight, me, and then Bravo Flight, Walter. Yeah.
Do you have any regrets?
This is like a question that lots of people ask me, like if I have any regrets in my life. In all honesty, I do not. I know it might be a surprise to people because, you know, I wasn't really the best kid, but I feel like everything happens for a reason. And I feel like if I didn't make those mistakes or like all those bad things, I wouldn't be the person that I am today. And I'm really happy with the way that I am and the way that I present myself. So no, I really don't have any regrets about life.
Do you have any last words you want to say?
Yeah, you know, we all go through stuff. You know, this whole year was a big drag for lots of people. Not just myself, but everyone. And I understand that we all go through hard times and we all have things going on in our lives, but that shouldn't matter. The only thing that should matter is where you want to be in life and who you want to be in life. And so just strive for that. Just use all of that negativity and all the things that like make into a positive. Like that's how I see things. You know, when people ask me, is a glass half full or half empty? I see things as half full just because I try to see the best of things. I try to see like the, you know, the positive side of things. Cause in all honesty, I feel like everything that happens, there's a positive no matter what. You know, for example, I've had many people pass away in my life and it sucked, but I feel like that helped me appreciate things more and have thicker skin to see, like, you know, to deal with things a lot more, I guess, nicer, you know, a little bit less hard. So everything happens for a reason. Don't worry about what's going on right now, because all that matters is you striving and working hard to where you want to be. And I'm living proof, you know, I'm living proof. I've gone through lots of things. I've gone through a lot of things. So don't let things pull you down, because it's not worth it. Just keep on going.
We want to thank all of our family and friends for the outstanding support. It made this past year a resounding success. Also, we want to say farewell to all of our senior cadets. We wish you all the very best. Returning cadets, we look forward to seeing you in August when we begin. What's going to be another incredible school year. Finally, remember who we are, Air Force Junior ROTC cadets. Please join with our choir as we finish up with the Air Force song.